We begin with an update on day two of the filing of certificates of candidacies for the 2025 midterm polls. Comelec says day one was generally peaceful, with only a few names filing, including 15 party lists and 17 senatorial candidates. But that is to be expected, with many waiting to file midway or towards the end of the window. Comelec says after the eight-day filing period, it will take around 2 weeks to filter the names and weed out so-called nuisance candidates. Senator Aimee Marcos is at the Manila Hotel to file her COC. Paige Javier is there, and she joins us live. Hi, Paige. Go ahead.
Hi, Michelle. Senator Aimee Marcos arrived here at the Quirino Grandstand near the filing venue, which is the Manila Hotel Tent City. Senator Marcos joined her supporters before going to the filing venue. It was a sea of red here at the Quirino Grandstand, where dozens of her supporters were lined up for a parade, which contributed to a fiesta-like atmosphere here in the Quirino Grandstand. So Senator Marcos walked from in front of the Quirino Grandstand, walking all the way to the Manila Hotel Tent City to file her COC. She is seeking re-election as a senator. She was joined by her children, among them Borgi Manotok. Her mother, former First Lady Imelda Marcos, was also in attendance to witness her daughter file her COC. Some of the supporters of Senator Marcos were here as early as 6 in the morning. Many of them were wearing the color red, which has been attributed to the senator. That color red filled this Quirino Grandstand with dozens of her supporters waving tarpaulin. They also had colorful paraphernalia. There was a marching band. There were majorettes. And it was an all-out fiesta here in the Quirino Grandstand. Shortly after Senator Marcos entered the Manila Hotel Tent City, her supporters also peacefully dispersed. The personnel of Ermita Police were here to make sure that they went to the back to the Quirino Grandstand, because as mentioned yesterday, they are avoiding the supporters or crowds to stay in front of Manila Hotel Katikpak Parkway Avenue, because they don't want traffic to be disrupted. Comelec earlier said these political stunts or any gimmicks of this kind are not prohibited, but they are asking the supporters and their aspirants to make sure that they are not disrupting traffic flow. They are not disrupting the general public. So we're seeing more police personnel here to make sure that these instructions are followed, and to make sure that there are no crowds waiting here in front of the Manila Hotel Tent City. As we speak, Senator Marcos has already entered, and she is currently filing her COC before the Comelec. That's all for now. Michelle, back to you.
Thank you very much for that update, Paige.